Yeah, thanks for having me. So we talked a little bit about, you know, the main reasons innovation is failing. And, you know, I really believe it's because innovation as a function is being used too much as a trade vehicle to do trade marketing, you know, extend shelf space, extend on brands, and we've really lost sight on the number one reason for innovation failure. And actually the number one reason for startup failure is failing to create something that solves a real consumer or customer need. And I think we've got to get back to that. We've got to get back to that, or else we're flooding the market with things with a very high failure rate. And one of the other big challenges is that with the emergence of technology and the fact that it's moving so quickly, primarily big companies need to get used to trying to solve these problems using new technologies, perhaps not the core assets that have made them successful. Because if someone's creating better technology and you are anchored on using what you've always used, and it's inferior, if it's an inferior way to solve that consumer problem, you are going to lose. And it's a very big dichotomy, I think, for big companies these days, because they've built their success on, you know, their competencies and their assets, but sometimes they're not actually the best way to solve problems. And that's the main dilemma we face. So in ZX Ventures, where I work, which is AB InBev's disruptive innovation team, you know, we're trying to be more flexible with whether we use the core company assets and competencies, and if that's not the best way to solve a consumer problem, we're working outside our core company and trying to be more flexible and build new skills and build new competencies. And that's how we're approaching it.